everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to a brand new edition of First Impressions. Since I didn't get the chance to do a first impression of GW's pre-order stuff last week, I'm going to go ahead and do those today, and then probably what I'll do is tomorrow's pre-order stuff, which you guys will see this on Saturday, and then tomorrow's Saturday preview stuff, I'll probably do a first impressions of those on Sunday morning. So that way you won't have two first impressions on a single day. I was thinking about uploading this one today on Friday, but I decided, you know, it's probably best to do it on Saturday, and that way we spread the videos out just a little bit. Anyway, though, let's jump in and see what GW has to offer us, what kind of Nurgle-y goodness they have, because there's some cool stuff this week, or last week. There's also some not cool stuff, which is one of the ones we're going to start with. We're going to start off with this mini called the Poxbringer. All right. This, to me, just looks like a basic Chaos Mutation type miniature. Other than, like, the guts hanging out, there's nothing really exceptionally Nurgle-y about this guy. It's kind of a blah miniature. I will say, there is one sort of pronounced feature on this guy that I really, really like that I didn't see last week when I first saw this guy, and that is the guy's tongue. It's actually rolling out like one of those, you know, party favor things, and I think that's really awesome. Other than that, it's just kind of a, you know, whatever sort of miniature. Not my favorite model for the week, but, you know, it's not the worst we've seen, definitely. $25 on this guy. Won't be adding this one to my collection personally, but, hey, you might be interested in it, so I figured I'd show it to you. Let's move on to mini number two. Get to mini number two. All right, mini number two is the Smallpox Scrivener. Now, I gotta tell you, this one is definitely a treat. This one harkens so far back to the mid-90s and the whimsy that all of 40K and all of Warhammer Fantasy utilized back then. This is such a fun, fun little miniature. There's a couple of really unique items of note here on this thing. First of all, I want to talk about the pen. The pen that this guy is holding is just gorgeous. I mean, I don't know that I've ever actually seen a writing implement in the Warhammer universe before, but the way they've done this quill pen is just absolutely beautiful. The only thing that I would have changed, and I didn't see it until I looked at it again this morning, his pen, if you look at it, has blood on the tip of it. It's not actual ink. But if you look at the writing on the scroll, it's not necessarily bloody looking. It could be dried blood because it's kind of a brownish color, but I would have really liked to have seen maybe a hole in the guy's leg that he would use as an inkwell. Like, just right there next to where the pen is, just a little gash or something that, or not necessarily a gash, but like an actual, like a hole that you could paint in with some, you know, nasty, bloody stuff, and that would be where he dips his pen to write. I thought that would have been a cool idea. They didn't go that way, but hey, you know what? That's not my, it's not my design. So, other cool features on this guy. I love the little dude in the bottom. I didn't see him the first time I looked at this. I went back later last Saturday and was checking these things out again, and it's so cool. This little dude at the bottom is just like, you know, gnawing on this paper this guy is writing on and just devouring it. And it makes me wonder in my head, you know, maybe maybe this is like the Nurgle version of an old school computer where you like load individual sheets of program dot paper into so that at some point it actually runs the program for you. Maybe this little guy is like some huge memory bank and everything the Scrivener writes down is this guy eats it, he remembers it. You know, he's going to town. I love how like enthusiastic he looks about eating this paper. It's so fun. It just, and to be honest with you, that right there, I said the last guy didn't look very Nurgle-y. This guy doesn't either. And then I remembered, you know, going back to the old days of Games Workshop, back in, like I said, like the mid to late 90s time when I first got into this game and painting and everything, I started to remember, so I started pulling out some books and looking at the Chaos stuff, the Nurgle stuff, it had this, like, clownish kind of happy attitude about it. Like, all the other chaos stuff was really serious, and I mean, you had the corn guys who were just, you know, these big warriors. You had the Zinchians who were these magicians and magic users. You had the what's the other one? Crap, I can't remember the other one. Doesn't matter. The Slaaneshis, who were like these like seductive, kind of very sleek design type miniatures. And then you had Nurgle, and everybody that was assigned to Nurgle was happy. They were like laughing and joyful and jovial. And I think that's what I'm seeing here in this guy that reminds me so much of the Nurgle, with this little dude on the ground here, and then the most prominent feature of this miniature, which is this gigantic freaking mouth at the very top of this thing, which, might I add here, looks a bit like a caricature of Keith Richards. Just throwing that out there, because that was the first thing that I thought of when I saw this, was that looks like Keith Richards singing. I kind of wish the top of that quill pen was a microphone. It would have been kind of cool. But overall, beautiful miniature. Very inexpensive. Compared to the Poxbringer that we had in the last miniature we talked about? Same price, $25. But look at the difference in the models. This one is so much cooler. It's so much more well-designed. It's got so much more detail on it. This is a cool mini. And this one is definitely one I'm going to be adding to my collection. Very, very, very awesome miniature. And really looking forward to picking it up. Now, moving forward, let's take a look at another one that wins the WTF award for the week. This is the Feculent Gnarl Maw. This is a tree, and it's a tree with fly eyes. That's what I'm calling it. I don't know what it really is, but it reminds me of the movie The Fly. It's interesting, I'll give it that much, but, you know, in the end, it's supposed to be something nurgly and creepy and everything, but in the end, it really just looks like a chaosy tree. And it looks like, to be honest with you, because of the way they got the layout of it, it looks like a piece of terrain. And I don't know if this thing is supposed to move around the battlefield or not, but usually when I see trees from GW, it's out of the Wood Elves camp, and those guys have legs and stuff. They can move around the battlefield. This guy reminds me a lot of those, like, what was it? The Warp World trees or something like that that we talked about a year ago on this first impressions thing. It's just kind of a bleh, sort of a dull looking miniature. Yeah, it's cool because it's got like a gash running down the very center of it with all these teeth, but other than that, yeah, I can leave this one in the store. You know, it's not going to bother me. $30 is the price on this thing. I'm not going to spend much more time on it because frankly, it's just not that interesting. I will talk very, very briefly about Harticulus Slimux. This guy, I think I talked about when we talked about the main Warhammer set that had come out, but I don't recall very, very quickly, or I don't recall right now. I will very quickly talk about this guy, though. Cool miniature. I like it a lot. 55 pounds. I'm still thinking UK prices because I normally do this when it's only available on the UK website. $55 is the price on this guy. I will say, this one looks very, very cool, but the front of him, I don't know if any of you guys remember this show from back in the mid to late 90s called Ah, Real Monsters, but the front of this guy looks like exactly like Crumb, one of the characters off of that show. It's a neat model. I like it. I don't think I'll add it to my collection, but it is a very, very cool miniature, and it's got a lot of fun, a lot of character, and a lot of whimsy to it. It is a miniature that has been out for a while as part of a larger kit, so I won't spend too much time on it, but it is a neat, neat mini. Now, final one for the day. Let's talk about Papa Nurgle. This is the Great Unclean One, or Rodigus, depending on how you want to put him together. $140 for this guy, but oh my goodness, what a cool, cool looking miniature. So, there are several different variants of this guy that you can build. He comes with, I believe, three different head variants, three or four different right-hand attachments, three or four different left-hand attachments, and then I think you can change his stomach around so that it's either like oozing intestines or it's like a mouth. Beautiful miniature. I mean, really, really, really cool miniature. My only thing that I will say that I don't like about this guy is that it doesn't really give you a rough idea of how big this thing is. I would really like, in the pictures from GW here, something that shows the scale of this of this guy compared to a normal size miniature. I know he comes with, I believe it's 130mm base, which is not quite 6 inches for those of you in the U.S. So like 5, 5.5, right in that range. So what I did was I took the base and I measured the base based on the picture, and then I flipped it up so I could compare to the top of the guy, and I figure this guy is about 6 inches tall, which to me seems small. And I only say that because I'm thinking in my head of when they did a couple of the other greater demons, the Bloodthirster of Khorne, and then the, what was the one from Tzeentch? I can't remember what the Tzeentchian one was called. But those, especially the Bloodthirster of Khorne, because he's like leaping into battle, you know, is so much bigger. And I know that Nurgle gets, you know, he gets points for his wideness more than his height, but he seems, if my scale that I'm using is correct, by taking the base and flipping it upwards and measuring the base versus the height of this guy, if my scale is correct, to me this guy is a little bit small. I think that he would have done better had he been about 8 inches tall, and maybe a little bit wider. So, I mean, you would have to have a bigger base for the guy. You'd have to probably go to maybe a maybe 170mm base. But overall, beautiful miniature. I mean, I love the feature of this guy. I love the fact that he's got these little Nurgling things just kind of hanging off of him at odd places. I love all the details that are inside the body in all of the cuts and the cracks and things like that. I'm looking at one of the pictures right now. He's actually kind of where he's rolling across the battlefield. There's like a little Nurgling guy underneath him, like getting squished, trying to scream and get help to get out. It's such a cool miniature. One of the features has this really awesome head with like a tongue shooting out with a head on the tongue. It's got this really nice bell that he can ring. It's so well done. Just such a beautiful model. And then we get over to Rodigus, which is just an amazing alternate miniature all in of itself. This guy really looks Nurgly when you turn him into Rodigus. He's got so many pustules and just oozing stuff coming off of him. It's a gorgeous, gorgeous sight. And I really, really like this guy. I will be adding him to my collection at some point here. But unbelievable miniatures this week out of the Nurgle camp. Can't wait to see what tomorrow holds for the new GW pre-orders. Although I'm afraid that with this coming out, all of this cool stuff coming out at once, I'm afraid maybe next week we might kind of fizzle a little bit. But overall, really, really great looking stuff, and I am looking forward to putting at least a couple of these models into my collection and getting some paint to them, because they are very, very, very sweet. That's all I got for you guys today. I hope that you have enjoyed this edition of First Impressions. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions so that you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Thank you once again for watching. It really, really, really means a lot to me. Also, please help support this channel by supporting me on Patreon. Every single dollar that comes in helps to support me and helps to support this channel to continue creating quality content for you guys. The link for that is down in the video description, and you can join up for as little as $1 per month. It's a great, great, great way to help out if you've received quality entertainment from me over the years. I would really, really appreciate your support. Thank you again for watching. God bless you all, and I will see you all in the next video.